What is good, everybody? Welcome to an Epic My Damn Toys video. Today we have another action figure set up for you guys, and today it is the biggest horror action figure setup ever. So you guys know it is now the month of October. It is time for all the horror stuff, all the Halloween, all the good stuff to break out. It's spooky season. So since it's spooky season, it's horror season, it is Halloween season, guys. We are preparing for it today, and we are getting into an epic horror action figure setup for you guys. We got all the NECA horror figures out here. We got some epic customization and bloody and all kinds of gore going on in the setup. If you guys enjoy horror movies, if you guys enjoy gore, if you guys enjoy Halloween, leave me a like and give me your favorite scary movie down in the comment section below. Who's your favorite horror icon? You like Freddy? You like Jason? You like Leatherface? Michael Myers? Let me know down below. But in today's setup, guys, we do have an epic WWE and horror action figure crossover. We got all the WWE superstars in the backstage area, and they were doing war with the horror action figures, and I'm super excited today. We got a lot of new figures featured. We got some epic stuff going on. So let's go ahead and get into it, guys, and break down this epic, massive horror action figure setup. So before we get into it, guys, I want to come all the way down here. I want to start down here in the bottom left corner right here. Let's go ahead and get into it, guys. You guys will see Chucky standing on this trash can. You know, he's not a very tall guy, so he does have himself standing on the trash can. He's got a hammer in his right hand. It kind of looks like he's holding that saw in his left hand, but that's actually Jason back there holding the saw. And Jey Uso, or Jimmy Uso, is actually in a predicament right here. He is trapped in that tire, and he's got his tongue sticking out, and I don't think it's going to end well for Jimmy Jey Uso there. I think that's Jey Uso. I could be wrong about that, but either way, he's not in too good a shape, Brad. He's trapped right there in the tire, and I think that it's going to end pretty ugly for him. If we come forward, guys, we do have Pennywise. This is the original 1990 Pennywise, and he is pointing and laughing. He's got his monster hand growing out right there, and Stone Cold Steve Austin is afraid. He tripped over the stretcher, and he is definitely running for his life. You know, I honestly wanted to have Stone Cold Steve Austin giving a stunner to Pennywise, but, you know, this area got a little cramped. I kind of did this one a little later, so I didn't have enough room, I don't think. Well, maybe if I move that, but I kind of want to create some chaos and stuff like that. So Pennywise did trip up Stone Cold, and Stone Cold Steve Austin's looking pretty deathly afraid there, but I still like this fix up here. The screaming head sculpt works perfectly for the setup, and Pennywise is looking good back there. We go forward a little bit, guys. You will see Leatherface, and he does have Goldberg strapped down to this stretcher, and you can see the fear on the face of Goldberg. I mean, look at him right there. Look at that face. So he is definitely scared. Who wouldn't be? You're strapped to a stretcher. Leatherface has the chainsaw wielding over your head. He's already got blood splatter all over him. This is going to be a bloody freaking mess. And if you notice, his arms aren't even strapped down. So he's so deathly afraid he can't even move. But Goldberg is strapped down to the stretcher. Leatherface about to cut this man wide open. And you could see the fear written all over Goldberg's face. And we come forward a little bit, guys. I thought this was pretty epic. I like this a lot. Now, I don't know if you guys can see this. This is the 2009 remake Friday the 13th. Jason here with the bag on his head. And he is stomping the head of Ty Dillinger into this tray. You guys can see the blood spatter on there. I don't know if you guys have ever seen this tray accessory. It used to come with old Jack's WWF figures, and on the other side of the tray there was a facial imprint, so I thought that it would be funny to have a wrestler face down on it and then have blood splatter, because, you know, he stomped him so hard that his head got, you know, smashed and caved in, and so the blood is leaking out there, and you do have the face on the other side. You can't see it right now, but Jason has stomped a mud hole literally into the skull of Ty Dillinger, so I wanted to include that here in the setup. Speaking of skulls crushed in, let's get back here. We have another Jason figure, Friday the 13th, and you guys will see Bobby Lashley. His head got smashed by these weights, so Jason just stacked up a bunch of plated weights. Those are 45 pounds a piece, so you add up the weight there, and you have Jason dropping it on your skull. I think your head's probably not gonna do too well with that. So his head did get smashed, and you have blood leaking out right there, and the head of the figure is actually morphed now. It is actually smushed. I don't know if you guys can see that from here, but the details are in there. You got the blood leaking down the face of Lashley, and his head is completely smushed. All the brain and guts is falling out there. So, yeah, Jason taking advantage of Bobby Lashley there, and it didn't work out too good for him. Pun intended. So, after this portion of the setup, guys, if we go up here, you guys will notice we have this massive Jason. This is a massive Part 7 Jason. I'm going to stand up so you guys can actually take in how big this damn thing is. You guys know how big the WWE figures are in the backstage area right now, but this Part 7 Kane Hodder Jason from Friday the 13th is holding Jeff Hardy's body onto this little wall right here, and you guys guys can see the machete over the top of his head. He is going to bring it down onto Jeff Hardy. And I don't know if you guys can see it again, but the details are there. Jeff Hardy is screaming his lungs out, and he is being held down by the hand of Jason. So I don't think that, I think he's probably going to cut right through the wall, right? I mean, that's a massive machete. A lot of force, big old Jason coming down on it. That's my favorite look of Jason in the entire series. Part 7 is my favorite. So that is a beautiful looking figure from NECA. And that figure is so detailed, and it's massive. And Jeff Hardy is, he's not looking too good, Brad. And we go just beyond that, guys. You will see a part 2 Friday the 13th Jason. And he pretty much just threw Neville through these walls, trash cans and stuff. That's why you see all this debris laying about, because there's so much chaos going on in the backstage area right now. But that's nothing too crazy. Just a little part 2 Jason throwing Neville through some brick walls. But we come forward a little bit. I want to get this one knocked out of the way real quick before we go back to the back row again. But we do have Freddy Krueger, and he has sliced the hand off of AJ Styles. So you guys can see down here, we do have the bloody hand that got chopped off. So here it is right here in all its glory. You guys can see the blood leaking out of the arm, and AJ Styles, his face says it all. I mean, he's yelling in pain and agony, and it makes sense. You know, if you lost your hand, you'd probably be in the same boat, especially if it was for Freddy Krueger. Not only are you fearing for your life, but your arm or hand just got chopped off. So it's a 2-for-1 deal on the shittiness. But I did want to get some usage out of this AJ Styles screaming head sculpt. Any screaming head sculpt works perfectly in these setups. It really creates the illusion, really brings it into feels. So I think that's pretty cool. Before we get into this big piece in the middle, guys, I do want to run through the back row right here. So in the back, we do have Michael Myers, and he does have Big E, and he's got his knife behind him, you know, wielding the knife. And Big E, you can see the fear all over his face. Very big theme here in the setup, is it seems like everybody is going through that. But Michael Myers does have the knife in hand right there, and it doesn't look too good for Big E. We move to the right, guys. You will see X-Pac, and he is getting choked out by Part 6 Jason, and you guys can see the tongue's out. He's squeezing the throat of X-Pac. He's got the chain wrapped around the neck. Not ending well for X-Pac right here. I love that Part 6 figure. The chain is really, really nice. I don't remember if it came with that chain or if that's custom made. I'm sure it came with it, but regardless, it is a perfect piece. It works perfectly. I love that figure, and I need more of the Part 6. I think I only have one Part 6 when with other figures I have multiple, so really need to get some more Part 6s, but that is a really nice piece. If we look right here, guys, you will see this massive, just like our Part 7 over here to the left, we have a massive Freddy versus Jason figure, and we have Finn Balor and Matt Hardy climbing on the back of Jason trying to take him out. You got the Demon King Finn Balor and Matt Hardy just trying to do what they can. You know, that Jason's wielding a big old axe, so, I mean, the rest of the field's probably not looking too good, but, you know, they're doing their best. They're doing what they can. I would suggest probably tripping him up or something like that. Figure doesn't have that good of articulation, so maybe they could get him down, and plus, he's on those big old, you know, platform boots back here, so he should be easier to bring down than somebody that didn't have on those big-ass platform shoes. But there is the big old Freddy versus Jason figure. If we come down to the back, guys, you will see this Chucky figure in the car, and he is choking out Seth Rollins with a bag over his head. So he surprised Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins trying to escape out of the garage door, and, you know, Chucky says, "Not so fast, my friend," and puts the bag over his head and is choking him out in the car. Stealthy move by Chucky. I know it's our second Chucky of the setup, but I think that, you know, Seth Rollins couldn't get away. You guys can see he's yelling, trying to get some, you know, get some air, but the more he screams, the more the air does escape the lungs, and there's not much air left in that bag, Brad. Chucky is choking out Seth Rollins right there. If we come forward, guys, this is the money piece of the setup. This is probably my favorite part of the setup. We got all the blood and gore and guts going around. So you guys can see here, we have this massive Jason figure that fills up the middle of the setup, and so this is the same kind of figure as our Freddy versus Jason, as our Part 7, but it has more articulation, and it is a beautiful piece. You got the head that does detach right there, and you have the mask. So the story that's being told right here is that Bray Wyatt, Roman Reigns, and Braun Strowman have teamed together to take out this Jason, and so, you know, he's a giant Jason. They got him down, they beat him down, they cut his head off, the blood is spilling everywhere, they put a machete in his head, you got the mask, you got Roman Reigns beating up on him, and then down here you even have John Cena hitting him in the thigh and knees with a sledgehammer, yelling to death. So, I mean, there's a lot going on with this. You got the big old knife that Bray Wyatt is holding right here. Braun Strowman's a bloody mess. This was a ton of fun to set up. I had a ton of fun setting this up. You got all the nice blood going on. The head of Jason right there, I think they took care of him. Maybe they can take care of the other big Jasons that are going on in the setup, as well as the rest of the characters in the field. We'll have to see about that. Let me know down below if you guys would like to see a part 2. But right here, this is definitely the money part. I love all this. I think it turned out fantastic. If we come forward, we're not done with it, guys. We have Pennywise, and he has his balloon, and all I have him is setting Triple H on fire right here. So Triple H is screaming in agony because of the flames on his back. I mean, my God, can you imagine being set on fire right on your back? I mean, I have a very sensitive back, so it would be over for me, Brad, for sure. But just beyond that, guys, we also have the other Pennywise, the 1990 Pennywise, another one of those, and the Young Bucks. I have them getting some offense in right here, so they are double super kicking Pennywise right there into the ambulance, so I thought that was a pretty cool shot, and I wanted to use the Bucks in this, but I wanted them to be super kicking, getting some offense in, so there is that. And then one of the final things we have, guys, is this massive Big Daddy figure, and he has drilled a huge hole into this ambulance and destroyed the entire thing. You guys can see all the parts flying out of it, and then you have Brock Lesnar on the inside of the ambulance, I guess trying to escape, trying to hide, and you guys can see it written all over his face. He has been found, and Big Daddy is drilling right through the doors right there, and Brock Lesnar is scared to death, so he probably needs to get the hell out of there. But that is not all we have. This is not all of the setup right here, because if we actually go beyond this door right here, or right behind the ambulance, you guys will see Kurt Angle is on the ground, and this Jason figure is about to bring this garage door down onto the throat or the sternum or the stomach or the waist or whatever the hell of Kurt Angle, and he is yelling there. So I don't know if we can get the right angle right here, but Jason is about to bring that door down on Kurt Angle. At first, this ambulance wasn't here, and then I added to the setup, so that is the reason why everything was not perfectly lined up right there. But I would love to know down in the comment section below what your guys' favorite part of the setup is. Please let me know down in the comment section below. Leave a like right now for all the details we got, all the extra blood. I'm gonna have to clean all of this up, so a like is super appreciated. Let me know down below who your favorite horror icon is down below. What's your favorite horror movie, your favorite scary movie? And, you know, are you Team Reese's, Hershey's, Kit Kat? You know, what's your favorite candy bar? What's your favorite candy to eat on Halloween? Please let me know down in the comment section, guys. I would love to know. Personally, for me, I love Twizzlers, man. The Twizzlers sour and sweet, like the lemonade and cherry or the strawberry lemon. I don't know what the hell they're called. It's like the two-in-one. They're like filled. Twizzlers, man, holy Christ. Those are absolutely fantastic. We're going just based off Halloween candies, like the little mini ones. I don't think you can go wrong with the Kit Kats. I don't think you can go wrong with the Snickers. I mean, I love Starburst. Skittles are great. But I want to know what you think down below, guys. So let me know what you think of the setup. Let me know your favorite Halloween candy, your favorite horror movie, what you love about Halloween, and leave a like for all of these details that we got right here. But that is going to do it for the video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. Just spam the comment section with all the different things, and I will see you guys in the next video. Let me know if you guys want to see a part two, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you. He didn't make it, Brad. He doesn't look so good.